My name is Fabricio Mattos. I'm a Brazilian guitarist, and we're here in Rio de Janeiro. I started my musical life when I was five with percussion instruments. I used to play in carnival parties with my father. I used to play tambourine. That's a very important instrument for Brazilian culture. And then when I was 8 or 9, I had a whole set of percussion to use during the carnival parties. So I started my musical life on stage playing percussion instruments. So more Brazilian than that, it's impossible, I guess. And then I played flute, I played violin. I was involved in choir and singing as well. And then when I was 12, I started playing the guitar. And never stopped, of course. So it's been some decades already that I've been playing this wonderful instrument. Being a Brazilian guitarist, playing the guitar in Brazil is something really, really good and really, really challenging at the same time. Because, well, it's really, really good because guitar in Brazil is the national instrument. So we actually have contact. As a guitarist, we can have contact with the classical world, with the popular world, with these pop worlds as well that are beyond any kind of recognition of music styles in terms of music style and everything. So we should transit a lot between styles naturally as guitarists. When we go away, when we go abroad to live in other countries, that helps a lot. Because first of all, it helps us to understand other people's cultures and other people's music styles. And it actually shows us how important is Brazilian culture as a musician, as a guitarist as well. And it's challenging because, as I said, the guitar here in Brazil is a national instrument. So every corner there's an amazing guitarist, and there is competition, lots of competition, but there is lots of space as well for guitarists in Brazil to do our stuff and to do amazing music. Nowadays, even though I have a history as a classical guitarist, I did my master's at the Royal Academy of Music in London and have a whole career as a concert guitarist, I'm doing my PhD in something else nowadays, something that relates to the history of performance spaces and layouts as well, something much more experimental in terms of how you deal with music production of performance events. So it's something, my life has always been something very wide. But I'm still a guitarist, I'm still playing, I'm still performing worldwide, but my interests are very varied. And I'm very interested as well in historic instruments, historical guitars. And I had a series of concerts. Not concerts, but lecture recitals at the Royal Academy of Music with historical guitars. There's a wonderful collection there. It's called the Spencer Collection. And I used some instruments of this collection and found some manuscripts within the collection as well and put everything together to create a series of lecture recitals that was very exciting, very challenging as well for me. So this is another side of my career as a classical guitarist. And I play in all kinds of situations nowadays as well, not just classical music, but also Brazilian music mostly, but also jazz and some more popular styles. As I said, I grew up within this world of the carnival of popular music, of natural heat of popular music, playing with my father, with wonderful musicians, popular musicians. So I will never leave this behind. I will always dedicate myself to both classical music and popular music, and I don't want to create barriers between one and the other. I have a website where I concentrate nowadays all the information about my projects and about my production, my concerts, etc. That's www.fabriciomattos.com. So fabriciomattos.com, and I'm also on Facebook, LinkedIn, etc. But all the information about myself and about my projects is on my website, and I invite everyone to access. There are like nice videos as well on YouTube, so just type my name and you'll find the nice stuff. I hope you all enjoyed my music and my history and this wonderful place in Rio de Janeiro, a historic place for Brazilian culture. And I hope to see you again. Please subscribe to this channel, wonderful channel that Bernardo created. And I hope to meet you somewhere in the world in some of my next concerts. Thanks.